So now let's take a closer look at dopamine. Dopamine is a naturally occurring catecholamine. It has direct alpha and beta adrenergic effects depending on the dose. Now, when a medium dose is given, like 5 to 10 micrograms per kilogram per minute, dopamine acts directly on beta-1 receptors, which causes an increased myocardial contractility and increased heart rate. When used in doses greater than 10 micrograms per kilogram per minute, alpha receptors are stimulated, which results in increase in systemic vascular resistance, in other words, vasoconstriction. Dopamine can be a very effective drug in treating hypotension with signs and symptoms of shock. Dopamine is typically used as a second-line drug for symptomatic bradycardia after atropine. Now, dopamine may cause tachyarrhythmias and excessive vasoconstriction and should be used with caution in patients who are suffering from cardiogenic shock with associated symptoms of congestive heart failure. Now, it's important to correct hypovolemia with volume replacement before we initiate dopamine therapy. The adult dosage for dopamine should be administered via IV, and its most common infusion rate is 2 to 20 micrograms per kilogram per minute. We want to be sure to titrate the dosage and drip rate to the patient's response slowly and carefully.